So you found yourself with $1,000. Maybe you just completed your tax return. Maybe you decided to sell some stuff on the internet. Or maybe you have got a second job as a hand model. And you're wondering, how can you turn it into something more? In this video, I'm going to help you create a mini plan to turn your $1,000 into $50,000. And we're going to, for a little bit extra inspiration, we're going to keep on going until we hit
$1,000,000.
I think I'd like to start with what isn't a plan. So often, the advice that we're given is don't drink coffee, don't go and eat smashed avocados, jump online and save or get a better rate for your car insurance. I don't know. And then, bingo bango, you will have saved a house deposit. That's not a plan. It's not inspiring and it's a little insulting. I'm recording this video from Melbourne, so to tell us to quit drinking coffee, that's like talking to someone from Brisbane and telling them to, well, not drink coffee because everyone loves coffee. And I don't know why, when we start talking about savings, the coffee is the first thing to be sacrificed. Down with anti-coffee discrimination. A simple plan should have these four key elements: your starting amount, the additional repayments you're going to add in, your investment returns, and your time frame. Add these four together and they should equal your goal. Before I move on to the detail and the numbers, this is probably a good time to tell you this is not financial advice, firstly. And secondly, I'm talking very high level, so the detail and calculations and assumptions, there'll be more notes down in the comments. So, your starting amount. Well, that's easy. We've decided that we're going to start with $1,000. And if we go ahead and add $0 per week, a 0% return, and we do that over 50 years, how much will you have? You'll have $1,000. Now, you may not think this, but one of the easiest things that we can do to change this equation is actually your investment returns. So if we just invested this $1,000, you can just set it and forget it, and there's no more actions for you. So what happens if we change the return to 7% per annum? Over 50 years, you will get $50,000. And if we change it to 100 years, you will have
$1,000,000.
Now, you didn't click on this video to be investing for your great-great-grandchildren, and they will most likely be cyborgs anyway. So we need to look at ways to bring down that 100-year time frame into something reasonable. And the best way to do this is additional savings. So extra payment per week, per month, or per year will significantly bring that time frame down to something you might actually be interested in. Same scenario again, but this time let's add in $100 per week or $433 per month. Now you're going to reach $50,000 in 7.5 years, and you're going to reach
$1,000,000
in 39 years. So these are the basic components of what your plan will ultimately look like, but we're all different. We're going to be starting with different amounts. We'll save different amounts per week. Some will invest, some won't. So how do you work out your plan that's right for you? So jump online and Google a compound interest calculator. I like this one from the calculator site. And the boxes that it gives you as options here are the same four we were just talking about. So top one is what you're starting with. Your interest rate is your investment rate. Calculation period is how long it's going to do the calculations for you. And your regular monthly deposit is your extra repayments. Put in some numbers and go ahead and click calculate. Have a play around with these numbers, and I know it sounds corny, but you know, click around, and what you're looking for is something that inspires you. What is a really good combination of, well, how much you feel you can actually save every week? What's a really a time frame that's not too far away, but it's still a really good goal? Having a play around these numbers, you'll be surprised. You will find something that kind of fits with you and what you're trying to achieve. I'm not gonna lie, the hardest part about all of this is those additional payments, the per week or per month savings, which is fine. But the question is, well, how much can you save? Is it 20 bucks a week? Is it 30 bucks a week? What about your partner? Can they do 20 bucks or 30 bucks a week? There are also other things like your annual tax return. Let's say you get $1,000 back in your tax return. Well, that's the equivalent of $20 per week. And your partner may find another $20 a week from their tax return. All these things start adding up. Maybe when your lease is up, you move a couple of suburbs out and try to find another $20 or $30 a week there. I'm not saying the cliche, don't drink coffee, sacrifice, but you'll be surprised that if you look at your bank account, look at your budget, look at your life, there may be certain things that you're happy to forego or sacrifice in exchange for the greater good or the bigger goal. But if you're not inspired by the goal, well, then you're not going to do it. You're just going to keep going the way you're going. So, you know, it really is about really understanding and really looking for that goal to make the appropriate sacrifices to that weekly savings amount. The other part that I really did skim over quickly in this video was your investment returns and how do you actually go about making 7%. I am going to do another video that will go into more depth. For now, if your investment time frame is 3 years or over, use 7%. If it's 3 years or under, use 4%. And I'll explain in another video why that's the case and where you can really find good returns consistently. The other thing that I haven't really talked about is the tax consequences of this strategy. So another video we'll do is the four tax zones that we have in Australia, how much tax you would or wouldn't have to pay, and also where you can find 0% tax legally. We'll go through that and more. So make sure you subscribe, like, follow us, and we've got plenty more videos coming. Cheers.